everyone. My name is Kritika Sehgal and I welcome you here in Tech Talks. I have with me today Mr. Mukul Mathur from Mahindra Electric. Hello, sir.
Hi. Hi, Kritika.
So, I have a couple of questions for him and I'll be asking these questions to him and let's get going. So, India plans to go green by 2030. So, don't you think that this is quite an ambitious aim for India right now? If we see it, if we look at the infrastructure and what we have and everything around.
See, this definitely is an ambitious target, but we must have some targets ahead of us so that we can plan accordingly. I very strongly believe that over last about 4 or 5 years, a lot of work has happened in electric mobility, not only in terms of two-wheelers and three-wheelers, but on cars and commercial vehicles as well. We also very strongly believe that the future of mobility would be electric, and a large chunk of that segment or that market will go towards commercial vehicles. That's how we are placed right now, and not only I'm talking of the company as such, but about the industry, how it is moving ahead. As you can see, that most of the electric cars now are in fleets.
Yes.
Not many cars are being sold in Zoom car is one company which is buying cars from us, and that will be operating vehicles in Hyderabad and Delhi. Similarly, Tata Motors have also come up with the electric vehicles. Energy Efficiency Services Limited have floated their tender for 10,000 electric vehicles. That is the largest tender in the world for electric vehicles. So all these vehicles are not really for personal mobility, but for commercial applications. Moving ahead from cars to commercial vehicles, we also believe that the last mile connectivity and last mile delivery, these are two very important segments which we must look at immediately. Last mile delivery is one thing, as I said in the morning, is one market segment which is going to impact electric mobility a lot. Hub and spoke models can create a lot of points where you can actually take the material from the hub and go for last mile delivery purposes. So as you said, these are ambitious targets, but since e-commerce is a large industry, fleet management is also a large market segment, so we believe that this is going to happen. It may happen not to the 100% to the level 100% electric mobility, but to maybe 60%, 70% will definitely happen.
So we hope so. And since India has set such an ambitious target for itself, so there are a lot of challenges that are going to come in a way. So what, according to you, are the major challenges that India will face in this league?
See, the major challenge today is the charging infrastructure. Till the time the charging infrastructure is not in place, most probably the personal segment will take a hit. So now Ministry of Power has come up with two different committees. They are deciding on charging infra requirements. One is in terms of the regulatory part, other is the commercial part. The regulatory part is largely complete. The commercial part is going to be complete. So yesterday itself, they have issued a notification that says that electricity will be considered not as a sale, and they have removed the binding of licensing for this. So Government of India is also pushing forward, trying to remove the roadblocks. One important segment, as I said, is a charging infrastructure. That is going to be the key factor here. And that is going to be removed or streamlined very, very soon.
Okay, so while other countries are moving towards electrified vehicles and then hybrid vehicles, but India is only, you know, setting itself towards electric vehicles. So don't you think it is going to be very challenging for India, so to, you know, keeping itself restricted to a particular kind of a vehicle in EV?
See, it is not about hybrid vehicles or mild hybrids or strong hybrids or pure electric. At least a beginning has been made, and in case you see the world over, the Nordic countries has maximum penetration of electric vehicles, where almost every third vehicle is now electric. They are going fully electric, and hybrid vehicles ultimately We believe that hybrids are going to take place in India also. Some government policies are going to also impact hybrids as well. Last year, the FAME India excluded mild hybrid vehicles from FAME India. But we are looking at having the FAME II scheme, which may include hybrid vehicles also. But hybrids are also going to be a polluting agent ultimately, because you and the cost of the hybrid vehicles would be more than electric vehicles, because you have two technologies inside. One is the motor or the electric EV technology. Second is the conventional IC engine technology. So vehicle-wise, the price-wise, the total cost of ownership-wise, hybrids are going to be a little expensive. So we believe that looking at India, India has its own characteristics, which may not be applicable to other countries. As you said, other countries are going in for hybrids, but we believe that India, being a country where economics play a very important role, so electric vehicle is going to be a better solution.
All right. Coming to the lithium-ion batteries. So as we all know, lithium-ion battery is a big deal, you know, storing it and then buying it and all these things. So it would be not wrong to say that lithium is going to be the new oil. What is your take on this?
See, I'm not a battery expert, so I think I may not be able to answer that with that authority. But see, in India, you have to have two type of technologies. One is advanced batteries technology, second is the conventional battery technologies. In advanced batteries, only lithium is considered as an advanced battery, which is acceptable across the world. So there are other chemistries also available as far as batteries are concerned, which can be upgraded or approved over the period of time, or evolved over the period of time for advanced battery technologies. But as lithium is the only one available, and that is only acceptable and approved the battery chemistry in India, so I think lithium is going to take the leap ahead.
All right, my last question for you would be, what India will change after coming into this sector, after bringing electric vehicles to the country?
See, the one very obvious one would be the pollution, because in India the biggest problem we have is the pollution. Delhi, where we all live, is one of the most polluted countries in the world. So electric vehicles are going to create a lot of change as far as the pollution levels are concerned. Also, not only pollution levels, in terms of noise pollution also, air pollution, all these things come to a better position in case electric vehicles are in India. And apart from that, the total cost of ownership of the vehicle, electric vehicle, would be much lesser as compared to an ICE engine. So that is one important change that we are going to look at in coming 4-5 years, or till about 2030.
All right, thank you so much, and we'll be back soon with another Tech Talk, and till then, bye.
Thank you.